Hey Bailey, how do I configure custom actions in Unity Forms?
I would love to show you that, Austin. Let me share my screen.
To configure custom actions within the Unity Form Designer, we select Custom Actions button on the top of our screen. Once we select that, we will see the Custom Actions pane appear on the right side of our Unity Form Designer. Any pre-configured custom actions for this Unity Form will appear in a list in this pane. To create a new custom action, at the very bottom of the pane, we will select the New button, and a new window will appear in the middle of our Unity Form. After naming and describing your custom action, we will move on to the conditions pane within the custom action configuration. In order to add a new condition, select the Add button, and you will be greeted with a list of all of the possible conditions the OnBase Unity Forms Designer allows. After scrolling through the list, select the one that best represents what you are trying to accomplish with your custom action, and hit OK. Once you hit OK, the action that you have chosen will appear in your conditions pane. As we can see, it is highlighted in red. Because it is highlighted in red, we know that there is no field specified for this condition. In order to specify a field, click on the field. Once you do that, a new window will appear for you to select any of the possible fields within your Unity form to complete the condition. Once you have selected a field, you now need to decide if the condition itself is going to do what you want. I want it to look to make sure that my first name is not empty. So after clicking once on the end of the condition, I was able to change it from empty to not empty. Now that our conditions are complete, we can move on to the Actions pane within the Custom Actions configuration. Similar to the Conditions pane, in order to add a new action, we can come over and select Add, and we are greeted with a different list of action types in order to complete our configuration. After scrolling the list and selecting the action we believe is going to work best for us, we are going to choose Make Field Required Custom Action. And hit OK. We now have a new action within our actions pane. Similar to the conditions, it is highlighted in red because we have not specified a field. In order to specify a field, we will select the field and be given a new dropdown of all of the possible fields that can complete this action. We're going to choose last name and hit OK. We now no longer see red, so there are no errors within our custom action configuration. So we're going to go ahead and hit OK. Once we hit OK, our custom action is configured, and we can see that by it showing up in our custom actions pane on the right. Now that we have it configured, let's test it. In order to test our custom action, we want to come back up to the top ribbon and choose Test Drive. Once we choose Test Drive, a test version of our Unity form will appear for us to test our new custom action. To do that, I'm going to populate my first name, which was the condition I set within my custom action configuration, and hit Tab. Once I hit Tab, we can see that our last name pane is highlighted in red with a little asterisk, and on top of the pane, we see it says, last name, this field is required, which is what we determined in the Actions pane of our custom action configuration.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. If you have a question that you would like answered on an upcoming question corner, please leave a comment below.